Welcome back. Human trafficking is a growing epidemic. There's an estimated 40 million people who are currently being trafficked or enslaved. And while the number of victims is staggering, what may shock you more is the reality that most are living right here in plain sight. Kimberly Demert, executive director of the Hugh Jackson Foundation, and Sylvia Colon from A21, who are here to talk about an event taking place this weekend that aims to raise awareness. Thank you both for being here. Sylvia is actually Gina DeJesus's cousin, is that correct?
That's correct.
And so it's so nice to see you again. Please tell Gina that we said hello, and we of course are still thinking about her and praying for her. But you have done a lot of work for her and for sex trafficking and those who are missing. So you know a little bit about A21. Explain to our viewers what that is.
So A21 is a global organization working really hard to abolish human trafficking and slavery in the 21st century. And what's really interesting and why I'm really excited about our walk here in Cleveland specifically, and it is in association with Journey Church is actually sponsoring the event through A21, is, and again, what makes it so interesting is that Ohio is ranked number 4 in the nation for calls for human trafficking, and that is ahead of New York. And I think that's pretty amazing statistics.
But A21 even stretches all over the world, right?
It's global. This is a global organization with real impact right here in Ohio.
So let me read you this. Slavery is often talked about in numbers, as we all know here. 1% of victims are ever rescued. Less than 1% of traffickers ever convicted. Human trafficking generates an estimated over $150 billion a year, which just makes you so angry. So what are these statistics rather? How can we change these statistics?
Kimberly, you wanna talk a little bit about that?
You know, honestly, it goes back to the consumer. Yeah. If you get rid of the consumer, you get rid of the supply. And it's basic economics, it's supply and demand. And unfortunately, most people who are involved as a consumer in human trafficking, they make excuses for their behavior. They think that what they're doing is harmless and there are no victims. And unfortunately, the victimization goes beyond the individual who's actually being trafficked. It affects their family, their communities, your local government, your hospital systems, your healthcare systems, everything from beginning to end. Everybody suffers as a result of human trafficking.
Kimberly is with the Hugh Jackson Foundation, which we've worked together several times. You guys are doing wonderful work, of course, with Hugh Jackson, the Browns head football coach. So tell us a little bit about Hugh's foundation. And we guys have, you've even teamed up with Salvation Army. You have Safe House in downtown Cleveland. So a lot going on.
We have. We're very fortunate. We're very blessed. Hugh and Michelle have this wonderful mission as a result of direct knowledge and impact about human trafficking. Realizing the significance and the effect on family members and communities, they decided to take the platform that Hugh has within the NFL and really reach as broad of an audience as possible. So locally, we provide education and awareness, some program development for high schools, for teenagers, so they learn what it is and how to possibly avoid becoming victims of human trafficking. And we also work with agencies such as the Salvation Army in providing services to our victims to help them on their path to recovery and to survivorship.
And now you've teamed up with A21. You guys have a great walk that's going to be happening this weekend. Tell us about it. Booths will be set up.
Yes, we are thrilled beyond belief because A21 is a global initiative. Last year they were in all 50 states and in as many countries as you and I can count for every state that we have here. It is a global, unfortunately, it's a global problem. 600 to 800,000 human beings are bought and sold across borders every year. The statistics are staggering. When most people think about human trafficking, they do think about it in a third world country, but unfortunately, it is here in Ohio. The A21 walk brings that knowledge and awareness to Ohio and to Ohioans, and we are one of 8 cities that are participating in the A21
There's a
walk.
Day in the life of a slave that you can walk through at the walk, is that right?
Yes.
There's gonna be 6 installations, and there's many forms of human trafficking, so folks that come and walk will have an opportunity to walk through those installations, and I think it will really be life-changing for people that come. And remember, rain or shine, we're walking, and we hope that people come. And something really interesting, we were giving out flyers Friday in Tremont, and many of the people in Tremont kept saying, well, yeah, that this human trafficking happens in Toledo, right? And I had to remind people that 5 years ago, three young women, a mile and a half, were found and kept against their will for 9, 10, mm-hmm. and 12 years respectively. Think it can happen here? Remember that story.
That's right. We have to wrap this up, but as I was reading on 821's website, the vision is, in a single moment, a number can turn into a name, a tragedy into a victory, and a belief into action. So as we go to commercial break, mm-hmm. what can people look for? It's right in plain sight, your salons, on flights. What are some tips that people can maybe look out for?
Individuals who are being trafficked are taught to be submissive and subservient, right. and they are also taught to not make eye contact. Mm-hmm. Watch body language, know your children, know your neighbors, know who is involved in your day-to-day activities. If people are very vague about who they are, what they do for a living, and their ability to move about freely, that's a warning sign. Okay. Pay attention.
You can register. All the information will be on our website. Sylvia, thank you.
Thank you.
Again, tell Gina hi. And Sylvia and Kimberly, thank you again for being here.